Let's talk about an exaggeration of shooting. Now, typically when we think about exaggerations, the obvious one that comes to mind is volume, and that's what usually everybody goes about. Let's just shoot this shot 500 times till you're good at it, which is great and all. It's a method of exaggeration that people have used forever. Now, let's talk about a different exaggeration, which would ultimately be shooting with distance. Now, obviously the game is changing up quite a bit. The three-point shot is being more and more valued as the game has moved on. Everything from the guards to the bigs have become great and better three-point shooters from further and further. Now, what we want to look at with this one is making sure that we understand here, especially when we get to the further distances, of what the ultimate goal is. So even though you might be a high school player, this might be the only distance you have to shoot in games. And pretty much everybody has heard that from a coach on one side or the other of, we shoot from here, be up on the line. And that's great. If you can get a shot up on the line, obviously that's a much more high percentage shot in a game. But right now, since we're talking about training, we're talking about enhancing our shot, it's kind of common sense to a certain extent. If this is where I have to shoot in a game and I want to be more successful at this by moving back to, let's say, the NBA line, this shot, it's kind of needless to say, if I can get more successful here and be better at this shot, smooth this out, maybe change up my lift point a little bit because I'm farther out, it's kind of needless to say that if I move back up to here, I'm ultimately going to be more successful at this spot because my body knows how to deliver a deeper shot, which is now going to make this a little bit more effortless. Now, this is one of the most controversial things I always hear from coaches is, don't shoot from that far out, you'll ruin your shot, or don't shoot from that far out, we shoot up on the line. Now, this is what happens as a player, and again, it's just one of the things that gets really confusing when you can't really space this out, is we're seeing more and more players being able to shoot from farther and farther away. And multiple reasons why this is good, it's one, it's just the natural focus of basketball. Players keep finding ways to get better and better. And number two is, it really helps your offense because now they've got to pick you up sooner on the floor. It can really open up the other aspects of your game, your mid-range, attacking to the basket, because the sooner they have to pick you up, the more space it gives you to get to the basket. Now, to really increase your range, one of the things people don't talk about enough is actually shooting more shots from farther range. So this is what I hear a lot from players, parents, coaches. Man, when I shoot this far out, it feels like I'm pushing the ball. Well, one thing you gotta understand about shooting is a pushing, pressing type motion. Hey, so this is probably a combination of two of my favorite as far as like the exaggerations of shooting is not only distance but speed. Obviously, Trey has done a phenomenal job of this. It's the same exaggeration though, when you up your rate of speed on a shot and you just start forcing little errors through it, when you tone yourself down, your level of being comfortable is still much higher than everybody else's. So everybody else's normal shot is significantly slower than yours because you've really pushed your exaggeration of speed. And the reason he just leans into this is to try to get his momentum back forward. And that's kind of like the fun thing when you mess with this. Like you guys did one yesterday, Micah had you do a split landing. When you start messing with like all the different ways to land, all the different ways to lean, you just start shooting more out of feel. That's what's really nice about like doing some distance work too. Because typically if you think about it, other than like Curry, Trey, the only people who ever shoot from crazy deep, it's when they're like goofing off. But like, if you take it with a serious extent, is like, cause you guys are, I mean, crying out loud, like the death drill that Micah put you guys through, you guys shot like, you're hitting like 10 plus in a row at that point. So only thing you guys can do is like, move it back to the point where it's ugly. Cause like even this, like the only reason you guys are missing that bad is you're forcing speed. But like, that's what that feels like, is like this literally when you go back to it, just feels like, it feels like the high school line. It feels like it's, you visually stand at this and you just feel so close. So a lot of times what you'll see with coaches is the one hand shooting drill. So obviously that's where they just put the ball, they put it in your lift point already, and then they just tell you to get some lift on the ball. Now, I don't understand where the word lift started to come from because it's everybody just trying to avoid what you're actually doing. You're pushing and pressing through the ball. I'm getting to my lift point and then I'm focused on extending the elbow first to get that nice natural press through the ball and then overall get some power. So now this is what happens. If I start to try to shoot with more range and I don't know my lower lift point, then you can start to run into some issues a little bit. If I'm a shooter that only shoots from a high lift point and I try to get more power, now the dangerous thing becomes for me to get more power, I've either got to jump more aggressively or I'm gonna start pulling the ball back farther and now I'm essentially just throwing the ball and slinging it. What's big in knowing that range is knowing that I can drop my lift points.
Now, as it relates to improving range for a player, one of the things that we like to do is actually put people on a box in a seated position and ask them to basically create the power needed to shoot the basketball. Now, what this does is really forces a player to find what's most efficient in their movement as far as their upper body goes. See, if you really look at a lot of times when players are learning how to shoot, typically people are taught to shoot from the ground up. Legs are overemphasized in that way, and players are trying to develop all their power and really get all their power from their legs to shoot, which if you look at developing range, isn't necessarily gonna help you. It's not about just how much legs you get in your shot from half court. It would be how good your movement is and how efficient your movement is as it relates to your upper body. And that's really what we want to be able to focus on. So when we can put a player on a box and we take all their legs away, now that player is going to have to develop the power needed to shoot the basketball. And if they're going to develop the power needed, they have to have efficient movement. We actually had an NBA player sit on a box from the free throw line, and because their movement was so inefficient for them, they swung the ball far to the left side of their body. Now, from the free throw line, they actually airballed their first couple shots. Why? Because their actual movement, wasn't efficient on their shot, so in that way, they didn't have the power even to get the ball there from the free throw line. Now, they don't experience that typically because they actually have their legs present when they're shooting the basketball in real life. But once we took their legs away, they realized their upper body movement wasn't efficient enough to actually generate the power needed. Now, when we expand that out to the three-point line, now we're gonna start to see if your upper body can actually get the ball to the basket. This is why players like Steph Curry can shoot so comfortably from half court, while you could put a person who's built 6'7" and they can't get the ball there in the exact same way. It's not a power thing, it's not a strength thing necessarily, it's efficiency of movement. So one of the great ways that we've actually helped players find their efficient movement was sitting them down and forcing them to feel and really change their motion in order to find power from their upper body. And so the way you could think of this, if I'm shooting the ball and I'm swinging the ball way far to my inside to shoot it, that's not gonna be a very efficient, powerful movement. And so if I don't have my legs to help me, the ball's simply not gonna get as far as I wanna get it. Now, if I can sit myself down and know that I need to generate power through my arms, now I'm gonna have to find the most efficient movement possible, the most efficient path possible to not only get the ball to the basket, but get it there in an accurate way. And so the box is a cheat sheet, if you will, to help players find their movement, find the most efficient movement possible to not only generate their form, but also improve their range at the same time.
Picture this. Somebody shoots from three-quarter court. They're not gonna bring it above their head and shoot it. They're gonna probably shoot from more around their chest area because the lower my lift point is, the more power I can get to push through the ball. That's why overall we see players of different heights and different sizes, and even the smallest player can somehow find major range just because they know lift points better. You'll watch some really tall big players have no range to shoot at all, typically because they're a little bit stingy and the only thing they know is a high lift point. It's hard to shoot the ball from far distances when the elbow's already so far extended into the lift point. So what I like to have players do, especially when they know the parameters of their shot, they know the ins and outs of their mechanics a little bit, no matter what age they are, I've had players as young as first, second grade having them really already start to dial in NBA range because they understand enough of the mechanics of their shot not to change anything so dramatically that they're now throwing the ball, but just lowering their lift points and focusing on power. It's no different than when it comes to lifting weights. If I'm actually gonna get stronger, the weight actually has to go up. I've heard a lot of coaches before say, oh, you wanna get better range? Start, get more shots from inside the paint. And that's great and all. There's nothing wrong with mechanics on working on being tight to the basket. Overall, working on your form shooting, there's nothing wrong with that. But me practicing from 5 feet is not gonna increase my range back to 25 to 30 feet. Might give me a better understanding of my shot, but if I shoot 1,000 shots from inside the paint, that's not gonna increase my range farther back. That'll just get me good at shooting from that range. Now, what happens is a lot of times when we see young players out there, we'll start to see them land differently or turn their body differently. That's fine as long as they've never compromised their actual shooting form through their right shoulder. Overall, you'll even see NBA players when they shoot from really deep, they'll change the way they land. They won't land 2 feet underneath their hips, they'll land in what we call a split landing because that helps you lean the ball in a little bit more to get your elbow through the ball. So what happens is, yeah, little things can change as I go farther back because obviously I've got to find more power somehow. But by increasing our range back, moving back farther, now we move back up to the line we're actually supposed to shoot from, whether that's the high school line, the college line, the NBA line. You scoot back into those normal ranges of where you would shoot the three ball. Now those ranges just seem and feel effortless because my body knows how to deliver the ball from farther. See, the biggest thing that you can do as a shooter is keep exaggerating. Keep working on really expressing different movements, so when I go back to what the normal is, that's just effortless for me. Overall, we're seeing players shoot from farther, farther back within games, and it's just making them so hard to guard because I got to think about picking them up even earlier. Now, the offense and defense is so spread out, it's hard to really guard anybody right now. So what happens is now you're seeing shooters that are so good from farther ranges that now they're shooting three-pointers and turning around while the ball's in the air because it's physically just a layup for them. Now, they've experienced harder shots. They've experienced further exaggeration. So now the norm to them is just so easy. That's why if you look at even from college basketball to high school basketball all the way to the NBA, players are starting to break the mold on how far they practice from because they're starting to see, they're seeing the Steph Currys of the world, they're seeing the Trae Youngs of the world that are getting to the next level because they truly have that much range. It makes them physically tougher to guard, even though they might not be the most athletic players out there. They're tougher to guard because they have more shooting options because their range is so much farther back. What's up guys, Bryce Stanhope here with IPT. Make sure if you haven't hit that subscribe button, click it now. And then of course, once you're subscribed, turn on those post notifications so you can get all of our content and you can be the first.